basically a mystery story at its heart. It is a story about man's insatiable desire for land and, you know, bloodlust and how things that you think you're doing to get yourself ahead and get your family ahead are actually doing more harm than good. It's in that regard quite a modern story, quite an up-to-the-date story, even though it's not set in the current day. The Last Tiger was a book that I probably started about 10 years ago. When I was working as a journalist in Outback Australia, I had been handed this story that nobody else in the office wanted to do, which was about a guy in suburban Melbourne who had reckoned he'd seen a thylacine, a Tasmanian tiger, and he'd caught it on film. Now, I had just came from Inverness, which is best known for the Loch Ness Monster, so I wasn't overly concerned about the story. I knew readers liked a good mystery. So I looked into it and wrote the story up, and the next day when the paper came out, I was absolutely inundated with other readers who reckoned they'd seen thylacines when they were clearing forests, building new homes, putting roads down, stuff like that. And I researched something of the Tasmanian tiger, or the thylacine as it's known. And I found that this was a story that I was really, really interested in. The thylacine was an amazing creature. It had this huge 120-degree gape. It was an apex predator. It had this fearsome reputation amongst the settlers on Tasmania. One of the most interesting aspects of my research, I think, was the time I interviewed this gentleman in Southwest Victoria. He must have been in his mid to late 90s, and he could remember as a child seeing a Tasmanian tiger being brought to his small bush town in a cage. They were not the ferocious creatures of legend at all. They were actually quite unusual creatures, and marsupials like the kangaroo with a pouch, and very, very unusual with the tiger stripes on the back. Slowly over time, the idea of a story formed in my head. Migrants persecuted in their home country flee for a better life in New York. All of a sudden they rock up in Van Diemen's Land, the once notorious prison island of the British Empire, where the father is forced to go to work hunting tigers for the government bounty. The Tasmanian tiger was actually a very timid creature. There's a lot of stories of it crying like a baby when it was caught in a snare. And sometimes when a trapper would pick it up, it would just simply die of fright. And it was to the shame of the Tasmanians and Australia and the world, really, that we lost this outstanding creature. Miko's background is Lithuanian. A bit like my own, if you go far enough back in my family lineage. So Miko and his family escape that, and they come to Tasmania, where the father is forced to go to work hunting tigers for the government bounty, much in opposition to his son's request, who is actually reckons he's found the den of the last tiger. And father and son are pitted against each other over the future of this species and whether or not it will survive. There is definitely a strong theme of fathers and sons running through most of my work. I think most authors have their own idée fixe, they have their own preoccupations, and it's certainly one of mine. In this instance, I think I've explored the territory more than any of my other books, simply because it does come to such a shocking conclusion.